now have the series against Washington, Chicago, and Minnesota as the first points. Of course, go to Arike Ogunbowale, fifth in score.
And in both games, neither of these teams shot very well from beyond the arc.
So for Neil, averaging about 12 points per game. Howard, another three attempt. This one falls for the attack.
Finally, Atlanta hitting one
second of the season in their previous game against Washington. That tipped away, clogging the paint. Here comes Gray. Gray has numbers, sends it to Monique Billings for the finish at the rim.
And that's how Atlanta likes to start their break. They get the ball immediately off the rim. So far in this one, both teams attacking early.
To the rim, Danielle Robinson reaches and gets another two. This pace is back and forth. Santu Sabli might have taken a bump on the other end in that previous possession and has yet to go in the field as Arike Ogunbowale knocks down the shot at the mid-range. Doing too shabby in this season with the Wings. Inside to Tierra McCowan over Cheyenne Parker, and that length has been a problem for Atlanta deal. Well, Tierra McCowan with 6 points, 3 for 4 from the field. Arike Ogunbowale covered by Erin McDonald, but the movement to the corner, Dangerfield.
What, that couldn't be a better matchup from size, speed, and scoring ability alone.
That one just rolling in for Satu.
They weren't able to take advantage of those offensive rebounding opportunities.
Cheyenne Parker going at Kalani Brown. Reverse, okay. Less than 10 seconds, Cheyenne Parker going at Brown, pulls up. Nas Hillman, attempt, blocks. Again, Nas Hillman at the buzzer. Just a one possession game, the fight on the rim.
It's the movement. Bodies moving without the ball.
And when you get that, you get buckets from Ryan Howard. The fifth most points in the WNBA, about 82 points. Burton on the inside. Kalani Brown trying to go over Monique Billings and does. Natasha Howard has yet to score in this ball game because everything on the inside has worked.
Good defense from Alicia Gray. She's literally containing Ogunbowale.
Burton off the glass, able to finish in her second season with Dallas. As Kalani Brown goes to the other side of the rim, and Natasha Howard with her length finishes.
And then Washington this last game, what happened with Coach Tebow? He used his challenge early in the game and was not able to challenge the shot in the second half. It's Ryan Howard just a nice hero step through the paint. Dials her own number up.
This has been a well-balanced game. No one in double figures as Natasha Howard gets the and one. Was able to impact on both ends of the floor. It hasn't just been one person that's had to step in.
Excellent. Nice pass from Ryan Howard. Now Tillman was moving without the ball, cut across the lane, left her defender. And Alicia Gray just singing her praises in the post game, and she's been next woman up all season long, just doing whatever the dream needed to do.
Gray at the rim, you can count it. Ogunbowale left alone, dangerous words.
Made sure to focus in on that one. She was left wide alone, no one recovered.
Seagrass cuts back door, doesn't receive. Odyssey gives it back to Brown underneath. Easy look for 6-7.
Billings fell, so what did Brown do? Took advantage, knocked it down.
Ryan Howard a bit cold from the floor as the leading team. A lot of times it comes down to the pressure on the wing as well, making sure they can't get a good look on the interior. 5, Tasha Howard streaks inside and gets the assist from Arike Ogunbowale. Monique Billings in rhythm in the bucket, and another two for her. Possession game, active hands for Monique Billings. Ogunbowale with the hesitation move, takes on the team, gets the roll.
I mean, I tell you what, we know the impact that Kobe Bryant has had on her. We've seen the last two games, or the two of the last three games, two players as Alyssa Gray. Ryan Howard slowing things down right now, sitting at 8 points, 3 for 10 from the field. Gets the move towards the bucket. I give that shot a 10. Really, that's where it all begins, right? The communication on the defensive end, which Nia Coffey brought a great deal. Giant Parker, who missed a great portion of the first half due to foul trouble with three. Four-point ball game after the free throws. Miscommunication on the back end, and that cannot happen for Atlanta. Kalani Brown puts it off the deck. Natasha Howard, high arcing, long two. I believe not only in the vision, but also in themselves, in their role to make things work.
Absolutely, and Atlanta has led in bench scoring for most of the season as Kalani Brown gets a tough move. Atlanta's been trying to force a couple passes on the interior, but that's where that spacing has come from. Dallas has been able to deflect it as Ryan Howard gets her number called and knocks down the three off the screen, and that's exactly what Atlanta needs.
Gray tried to sky in, lost the handle of it. Nas Hillman picks it up, sends it up to Ryan Howard.
You don't miss a deep with Nas Hillman on the floor. You got to get it.
The look to Tierra McCowan, just a quick turnaround. Barry McDonald sends that one up, a lot of contact. Baseline jumper by Nas Hillman, count it.
The ball left, tip that outside, which is why Dallas got the ball back.
Over Cheyenne Parker, Tierra McCowan off the deck. There's just not much you can do about that.
Parker met her right there as soon as she came off the screen and did not foul.
In rhythm, Cheyenne Parker assists, goes
immediately off the miss. Atlanta was off and running. Found the right person at the right time in the shot clock. The Odyssey Sims just cut right to the free throw line. Nobody meets her.
So turnover for Atlanta gives them two more points and a quick timeout by Tanisha Wright.
She had that question post game last game. And
the players were almost about to answer. She said, wait a minute, that's a question for me, right? And I think Tanisha Wright wants to win regardless. They're outscoring Atlanta in the paint, 42-22, coming off of a game where they scored 60 points in the paint against Seattle. And they've done that three times this season. Arike Ogunbowale with back-to-back. Five rebounds, 6 points, and the strip for Ryan Howard.
Excellent, excellent hands defensively. Howard was deep, but was able to strip the ball, and this is what it results into. You get a stop on one end. They just knocked off 6 points within about a minute and a half span. There was plenty of time.
And because Cheyenne Parker was a big part of that, Arike Ogunbowale knocks that one down.
And so while that's not a terrible shot, it's a bad shot at the time in the possession. That was the first shot down. The entire team had even recovered down the floor, and this is what happens. Quick shots so far and three rebounds. But the consistency has done it every game all season long.
Satu Sabali is starting to cook.
So many bunnies right at the rim, not converted for Atlanta.
Might have been a little bit of a heat check.
Oh, it was definitely heat check. Harry McDonald says, you tried it at that end. I'm going to come in and provide.
They have earned the right to play on as Dallas will go on to win their 22nd game of the season and prepare next week for the first round.